Next at 10, a body found in a storage locker.
And we have the body camera video that captures the disturbing discovery.
Yeah, you can close it.
Hear the shock from deputies and the latest on this investigation.
Plus, the president speaks for the first time since bowing out of the upcoming election. That's all tonight, right here on Fox 35 News at 10. A changing of the guard.
So I've decided the best way forward is to pass the torch to a new generation. That's the best way to unite our nation.
President Joe Biden says it's time to step aside for the good of his party.
It's been the honor of my life to serve as your president. But in the defense of democracy, which is at stake, I think it's more important than any title.
In likely his last Oval Office address, the president gives an early goodbye to the country. In our You Decide coverage, the president's speech is our top story tonight, and it's the first time we're hearing from Biden since he announced that he would not seek re-election for November. Thanks for joining us. I'm John Brown.
Good evening. I'm Luann Sorrell. It was a short speech, a little more than 10 minutes. Fox 35's Hannah McKenzie is joining us live in the Alert Center tonight with a closer look at what President Biden said tonight. Hi, Hannah.
Hey, Luann and John. With photos of family behind him, the president sat behind the Resolute desk talking about the importance of democracy and passing the proverbial torch to the next generation. Biden did throw some support behind Vice President Kamala Harris, but not very much. And according to Hanley, that's likely because the Oval Office presentation is meant to be nonpartisan. Hanley adds Biden's focus was more on why Harris should be his successor versus why former President Trump should not be. In fact, he didn't mention Trump's name once during that entire speech. Live in the Alert Center tonight, Hannah McKenzie, Fox 35 News.
Hannah, thank you. A Fox 35 exclusive now. Neighbors call it a death pond. Fish and birds found floating in the water, and now the community in Volusia County is calling for action.
Fox 35's Kelsey Cairns is in DeLand, and she spoke with residents who are concerned for their own safety.
Thanks, Kelsey. All new at 10, check out this brush fire in New Smyrna Beach. Volusia County Fire Rescue says it was caused by a lightning strike this afternoon. That fire spread to more than 14 acres. It's right along I-95 and State Road 44, right near mile marker 248. That's just south of the Advent Health Facility. Several agencies responded and say this fire is now 100% contained.
The state attorney's office now questioning the truthfulness of the Osceola County Sheriff. Andrew Bain believes that Marcos Lopez lied about the photo of Maddie Soto's lifeless body that was posted on his Instagram account. But the sheriff says he's been honest during the whole investigation. This involves Sheriff Lopez reportedly telling conflicting stories, one of which is under oath to FDLE. But when asked about the photo during a radio show, Lopez allegedly said that it wasn't actually the body. Bain wrote a letter to Sheriff Lopez referring to something called the Brady List. If Lopez is added to that list, it would simply mean that prosecutors may consider him to be unreliable due to an offense like this, and that can make him a liability on the stand. We did reach out to Sheriff Lopez and got this statement. It reads in part, "The state calling the sheriff's integrity and credibility into question is not right. The state has misinterpreted a quote from the sheriff explaining what the photograph depicted. The photograph showed clothing, but identifying features of a body were not visible. The sheriff's statement was not a lie, nor was it untruthful." Now, Bain has formally requested an internal investigation into these statements. Once his office gets those results, they will decide whether to add Lopez to that Brady List.
The group that will ultimately decide the permanent Pulse Memorial and what it's going to look like met for the first time today. The Pulse Memorial Advisory Committee gathered at the Kia Center to discuss plans. Members have not yet spoken about specifics about that memorial. Today, each member introduced themselves and shared some of their goals for that memorial. A big theme today was unfinished business. Many expressed that 8 years without a permanent memorial is way too long.
They were kids, they were brothers, their fathers, sisters, mothers, cousins, best friends, partners, husbands, and wives. And I believe that the conversation can be, my hope is that we can steer the conversation towards this unity.
The committee will meet again tomorrow at the Kia Center. After the meeting, there will be an open house where the public can pitch their ideas. We are following some breaking news tonight out of New Smyrna Beach. We've learned that at least three people have died in a really bad crash along US 1.
Yeah, police say the highway is going to stay closed for at least the next few hours. It happened near the New Smyrna Beach airport at around 8:30 this evening. Police say there was at least one motorcycle involved, but they're telling us there might be more. After the crash, some of the vehicles also caught on fire. The victims will not be identified until their families, though, are notified.
Central Florida is coming in hot. This July is the hottest on record, and there is no sign that things are going to be cooling down anytime soon. Fox 35 Storm Team meteorologist Noah Berggren joins us tonight.
I talked about this on the radio show. It's like a 3 or 4 shower day. Every time you turn around, you're like, I need to shower again. Yeah. It's just nasty out there right now.
Yeah, John, and we said this in May, if you remember. May was the hottest May on record this year. June, I think, was in the top 5, and now July will be another month. That's a historically hot month in Central Florida. 95 the high today in Orlando, Leesburg, the Villages, Ocala, 92 in Melbourne, 91 Cocoa Beach. When you add together all the daily highs and lows, that's how you get the average temperature. It's currently 85.8 this July. That ranks number one all time, including the Executive Airport, which is back to the late 1800s. The record all time is 85.3 for the month from 2016, and I do think we'll either tie or break that this year when the month is over with. For the majority of us, the rest of the evening will be quiet. Just a little downpour near the theme parks and Disney World, some lightning that's tracking towards the Claremont area, but that's it for tonight. Temperatures are still in the 80s. I mean, it's almost 10:30 at night, and it's 84 in Orlando. That's hot. It's still a heat index of 93 in the city, even still feeling like 100 in Titusville, and it's 10:30 p.m. Yeah, that's when you know we're in the dog days of summer. All right, so tomorrow, mid-90s for highs, about 95 again in Orlando. Heat index will peak around 105. Average high tomorrow is 92. Historically, the record is 99, back from 1962. But check out even in the morning, 11 o'clock in the morning, already feeling like 97. We've got some new details about storm chances in the tropics. We'll go through it for you in the next half hour, guys.
Thanks, Noah. Parking problems in New Smyrna Beach may be about to get better. We've reported on the lack of parking spaces in that town for several years. So now an outside consulting company called LTG believes that parking meters could help solve the problem. Another option would be real-time updates through mobile apps. The consultant suggests partnering with companies like Waze, Google, or even Apple to let people know where to go. LTG started researching this earlier this year, and they will present their findings at an upcoming community forum that takes place next Thursday. None of these changes are set in stone, which is why they are urging people to come out and give them feedback.
The first day of school in Lake County is now just 17 days away, and now students and teachers will have a new layer of security in the classroom. The district is using upgraded technology to get law enforcement to campus faster in an emergency. Now teachers are required to wear a panic alert system. This school year, it will now automatically sync with the emergency system used by law enforcement. The district's director of safety and security showed Fox 35 how it works.
If I became aware in this area that there was an active assailant situation, then I would notify and press on my Syntegix badge a certain number of times, and that would activate an active assailant alert. And with that, we would have strobes throughout campus to give a visual cue that there is a situation. And then there's intercom takeover, there's computer screen takeover, and then what is new and dynamic is that it also integrates our camera system into the real-time crime center off of the activation from our Syntegix alert.
The district says once the alert is activated by a staff member, the 911 call automatically goes through. It also immediately pulls up the 4 closest cameras so law enforcement can see exactly what's going on. Every single staff member is required to wear the badge, including substitutes. Fox 35 News is just getting started tonight. Still to come, a story you will only see right here. A man shot in the face and lives.
I didn't even realize I was shot until I started feeling the blood on the back of my head.
Tonight, that victim speaks exclusively about his fight for survival.
Plus new details about how suspect Thomas Crooks carried out an assassination attempt on former President Trump. The new information released today by the head of the FBI.
And a plane flying way too close to the ground.
I think the thing that I first saw that really concerned me was how close to the water we were.
Hear from a passenger on board as she tells her husband she fears for her life. If you're not streaming Fox 35 on Fox Local, you're missing out. Yeah, we got your news and weather, but there is so much more. Every night, stream Fox 35 Originals, politics in the battleground states. Newsmakers shaping our community. Strategies to save your family money. Secrets for your next trip to the theme parks. Go backstage with celebrities. Plus, for sports fanatics, it's game on. Download Fox Local and start streaming now.
All right, things are quiet in the tropics. They'll stay that way for the next week. However, once we get to August, this map will not be quiet. We've got some new details about that long-range outlook coming up shortly.
A Fox 35 News exclusive. This man right here, shot in the head. But what he did next is truly unbelievable.
Yeah, it really is. This map shows that he ran to his friend's house, which is more than a mile away. Mm. Now he's on the road to recovery and sharing his experience with Fox 35's Chris Lindsay. In Seminole County, a big step forward to fixing flooding problems in Sanford. People who live in the Midway neighborhood say it floods almost every single time that it rains. Well, county commissioners now reached a deal with a dozen property owners to gain rights to their property. It lets county crews do all the work they need to do to prevent more flooding.
The construction of new storm drain structures, upsized storm drain piping, and also new stormwater management ponds.
County officials are still speaking with 50 other property owners trying to convince them to also sign on to this project. Officials say it will cost about $26 million, and if everything goes as planned, the Midway project could be finished by early 2027. Still to come tonight, the investigation into the assassination attempt of former President Trump continues.
The new details the head of the FBI just shared today about the shooter's preparation and the crazy video that got an Amazon driver fired. Look at this. Yeah, when this surfaced online, he was in trouble. See the outrageous behavior that was all caught on camera.
The head of the FBI was grilled on Capitol Hill today. He says there is still now no motive as to why the shooter attempted to assassinate former President Donald Trump.
Yeah, today, Christopher Wray testified before the House Judiciary Committee and shared details of the shooter's actions prior to the event. Fox 35's Aisha Hosni has the highlights and reaction.
In the Fox 35 Sports Zone tonight, UCF football has released its list of its themes for all the home games. The first bounce is August 29th against New Hampshire. That is the first home game of the season. Family weekend is the following week. Military appreciation is October 12th. Homecoming is October 26th. And the big space game everyone is waiting for is November 2nd. That's followed by senior night on November 29th.
Also in the Fox 35 Sports Zone, the State Board of Education ratified a plan today that will allow high school athletes here in Florida to get paid through their name, image, and likeness, or of course, NIL deals. The plan will allow student athletes to brand themselves for commercial endorsements, promotional activities, and even through social media. But the students cannot endorse products like drugs or adult content. The Board of Education chairman says the Athletic Association must now prioritize the protection of student athletes, most of whom are going to be minors.
At the end of the day, the number one priority is protecting the student athletes. This could be a great opportunity for some student athletes, right? But we want to make sure that they do it in a manner that they're protected and not exploited.
High school athletes would be prohibited from being paid for on-field activities, hiring agents, and even receiving awards that are unapproved by the Athletic Association. And high schools will not be able to use promises of NIL deals to recruit players.
From Fox 35 Mission Control, tomorrow, NASA and Boeing officials are expected to hold a news conference to provide the status of the Starliner crew. Astronauts Butch Wilmore and Sonny Williams have been stuck on the International Space Station following thruster failures and helium leaks on the Starliner capsule. The mission has exceeded its 45-day battery window. Yesterday marked day 47. There is still no date set for the Starliner's return.
an Amazon worker out of a job after being caught on camera driving on the sidewalk. Look at that guy. A car passenger in Georgia caught the act and then posted it on TikTok. Take a look again. This is really unbelievable. The witness believes the driver was going about 35 miles per hour on that little sidewalk. Amazon says the driver no longer works for the company. I just want to know why. That's my only question. The road was open.
It was clear.
Yeah. All right. Next, here on Fox 35 News at 10, a woman on board the plane that dipped to about 150 feet above the bridge there in Tampa is speaking out.
I knew that Tampa Bay was way too close to us, and that was my big red flag.
Wait until you hear why she started recording in the first place.
And we are saving you some money tonight in the Fox 35 Pump Patrol. Gas is $3.29 at the Citgo on West Beresford Avenue and Spring Garden Avenue in DeLand. Stay with us, your full forecast right after this quick break.
All right, new tonight, we're getting our first look from inside that plane that was only about 150 feet from the Courtney Campbell Causeway there in the Tampa area. The Southwest Airlines flight from Columbus was coming into Tampa International when it got a little too close to the ground for comfort.
Fox 35's Evan Moon shares that passenger's scary experience. The tropics are quiet for now, but things could start heating up in about a week or two. Fox 35 Storm Team meteorologist Noah Bergeron is back with us now.
Yeah, we're getting closer to the peak of hurricane season, so here we go. Right, buckle in.
And I think once it starts, it's going to be weekly. We have storms this year. Probably. We'll hope none of them hit us. But I wanted to tell you quickly, too, that Saharan dust, the effect of that gets overplayed. And I've tried to explain this the last few weeks, that Saharan dust solely doesn't prevent tropical formation. That's number one. It's only maybe half the recipe. We'll go through more of that why tomorrow when we have more time. But let's talk about early August for here and now. So a big area of high pressure over the Central Atlantic, that's going to create steering flow off the coast of Africa into the Caribbean between the 10th or the 1st and the 10th, which is not that far around the corner. So what we're watching is this tropical wave that's currently on the western part of Africa. It's a pretty big one. I mean, look right there. It's a large wave. It's very disorganized. There's no center of circulation or anything yet. It's just a whole big area of thunderstorms. But that's going to merge over the ocean water tomorrow into Friday. Now, here's my personal opinion. This is not the National Hurricane Center's forecast. I just hand drew this in the last hour. This is where I think we're going to have to watch between August 2nd and 6th in this yellow area, coming towards the Caribbean, maybe even the southeast U.S. beneath this dome of high pressure. It's possible we have some kind of tropical cyclone formation, and the conditions will get very favorable. Now, does something go into the islands and fall apart? Does it curl around this dome? Does it come towards the Gulf? Way too early to speculate, but it does look like that this possible storm, which again, Debbie, that's the next name up this year, probably will kick us off to a very busy spell as we go through August and then into the peak part of the season. Tomorrow, basically a carbon copy of today. It's really hot, still really hot into the weekend, but those rain chances will come up for areas from Orlando east as we head into early next week, guys.
All right, thank you, sir. Let's take another live look outside. There's the view over downtown Orlando this evening, and you're watching Fox 35 News at 10 on this Wednesday night.
Help kids in need head back to school. Join Fox 35 and our partners to donate school supplies. Just grab a list, shop, and drop off your donations. The Fox 35 Backpack Brigade, August 2nd at this Walmart Supercenter.
Fox 35 News is sponsored by ePass.
A Fox 35 exclusive, we are the only TV station here in Central Florida to take you on the new ride at Busch Gardens.
This thing is so cool. It's an inverted roller coaster called Phoenix Rising. And of course, David Martin went for a spin several times this morning.
It's smooth. I loved it. In fact, Paolo and I got a chance to ride it this morning at 7:30 in the back seat. Now, I've had a back seat ride and I've had a middle seat ride. I'm going to tell you, Eric, straight up, I enjoyed the middle seat more.
Well, middle seat is great, but once you get on the front seat, which I know you're going to do before you leave, you're going to have that great view of the Pantopia area. You have a great view of the belt, animal belt, as you go up and down that lift and around the curve. So great views of the Pantopia Village, which also has Falcons, Fury, and Scorpion. So once you get in that front seat as well, it's going to be a tremendous ride.
Wow. That is so cool. It's like the swings in a roller coaster. I love
that's
that.
That's wild.
By the way, it's going to be open to the public very soon, and it's going to take riders on a lot of twists and turns with great views of the entire park. Riders have to be at least 42 inches to hop on board, though. All right, Disney officially launched its Lightning Lane MultiPass today to reserve rides and shows ahead of time. This replaces Genie Plus. Disney Resort guests can make reservations at least 7 days in advance. Everyone else can pick 3 days ahead of time. Guests are allowed to make up to three reservations in total.
Well, the late news at 11 is coming up next.
And Fox 35's Hannah McKenzie is here to kick things off. Hey, Hannah.
Hey, guys. Don't say sweet dreams just yet. Tonight on the late news at 11, we are taking a closer look at the beds the athletes at the Olympics will be sleeping on in Paris and why they're causing quite a stir and a few giggles. Stay up with us to find out.
Fox 35 News is brought to you by Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm.